In other news, education agencies here in the Philippines taken aback by the sudden closure of Colegio de San Lorenzo. The Commission on Higher Education says the school may have failed to reach its target number of enrollees, forcing it to fold. As for the education department, it said the college did not inform them of their plans to close.
Last week lang sila nakipag-usap sa KTNCR official namin, kaya kami din nabigla at nagpatawag ako ng meeting kahapon at mamaya mag-uusap ulit kung ano ang pwedeng gawin para tulungan ang mga estudyante na apektado.
Kami po ngayon ay magtatry na lang makipag-coordinate. Sana po may mga ganyang private schools pa na lalapit para masabi sa atin kung ma-absorb nila yung mga estudyante. Yun. Regarding naman po dun sa closure mismo, I think we'll have to study kung ano ba talaga yung pag ganyang biglang nagsasara yung private schools, ano ba yung kung meron bang sanctions o wala na maipapataw ang Department of Education.
A Philippine lawmaker also wants to ensure a smooth process for displaced Colegio de San Lorenzo students as they transfer to other schools.
It's very important. Dapat hindi yung bigla na mag-decide na lang isasara at the time when they are supposed to open, doon pa nila mali ang timing, kumbaga. Hindi tama yun. Dapat may sufficient notice sana. Gusto namin gawin, matulungan namin ang mga magulang at mga estudyante na makalipat sila sa ibang school. At kung kailangan, nakausapin namin itong mga school na ito para i-accept yung mga estudyante at yung kanilang bayad ay didiretso na manggagaling sa Colegio de San Lorenzo.
The Colegio de San Lorenzo in Quezon City officially announced its permanent closure Monday. The same day it was supposed to start classes for the school year, drawing outrage from students and parents. The Philippines logged over 28,000 COVID infections during the second week of August. The country also averaged 4,000 daily cases from August 8 to 14. That's up by 3% from the week before that. But the new figures showed improved numbers in the country's positivity rate, which fell from 18.7 to 18.1%. ABS-CBN News data analytics head, however, warned this doesn't mean the threat of the virus has waned.
Kailangan sustain, dapat yung mga nakikita nating improvement sa numbers through time, no? Hindi lang isang araw, dalawang araw, kailangan at least 1 to 2 weeks of monitoring. Hindi lang sa positivity rate, hindi lang sa cases, kundi marami din tayong ibang mga numbers na titingnan. Especially yung ating healthcare utilization rate, dapat tingnan din natin, as well as yung mga severe and critical admissions. So napakaraming ibang numbers na ating kailangan bantayan.
The health department seeking to ramp up the country's COVID vaccination coverage ahead of the opening of classes next week.
Sa Department of Education, hikayatin pa rin natin siyempre ang ating mga magulang para pabakunahan ng mga bata. Let's have safety officers in our schools and let's follow the minimum public health standards.
Over 20 million COVID vaccine doses have gone to waste in the Philippines. That admission coming from the Health Department during Monday's Senate Health Panel hearing. The figure makes up 8.42% of the country's total procured jabs. Senator Rizzo Ontiveros called out the agency for its inefficient vaccine administration. The DOH officer in charge, Maria Rosario Vergeres, says they are now working on ways to avoid this.
To prevent further wastage in the future, we have analyzed our current stocks and how we are consuming. So we have different scenarios that we have identified for which, based on the scenarios, we are not going to procure anymore any of the vaccines until the end of the year. Based from our estimates, with the first booster shots and the second booster shots, and based on the uptake of vaccines right now, we will have enough for us to reach our targets.
Latest data show more than 90% of the government's target population have completed their primary COVID vaccine series, but booster uptake remains low.